Hi, friends! How are you? This is the Chaldonut speaking, and welcome back to the Talos Principle. I've been thinking a little bit about our situation here, and I've realized, you know, we actually have a lot of information at this point. And it's time to decide what we want, as far as decision-making, what we're going to base our decisions off of. And I think I have a pretty good idea, because as I've just said, we do have most of the pieces of the puzzle now, or at least most of the important ones. We don't need information, really, about the EN and EL project. I mean, it'd be nice to have, but it's not essential. Because we know enough to have a pretty good understanding of what's happening. So, anyway, what I want to say, guys, is the real question marks we need to figure out are Elohim. I mean, we don't know how much authority he has over robots that pass through the simulation. We don't know exactly how he's controlled, if he's just as if he has just as much free will as us, or if he's controlled by some transcendent human from Ian or EL. We don't know. That's unclear still. So Elohim's a question mark. Some of the details about Ian and EL and what happened to humanity are still unknown, but the big thing for me also is how far ahead, how far in the future, relatively speaking, are we from Ian and EL? How many iterations of the simulation have occurred, and how long has it been since they developed the simulation? And that kind of plays into Elohim and how he's controlled and all that. Anyway, I'm coming back to World 1 because I realized that we got that message from the other robot, or the other AI, in the Land of Death, and we weren't sure if it was just us kind of being tricked, or if there was actually another robot in our world. So I figured we'd come back and check the first one, and see if we found anything, just to be safe. Oh yeah, we've got this. Right, those haven't changed. The QR codes don't really seem like they change at all. Anyway, guys, I didn't actually explain the most important thing. I talked about some of the issues, the unknowns, the question marks. But for me, guys, the biggest thing that I want at this point, aside from the question marks and knowing more, I want to go basically be where that area is, you know, through the hidden door in Elohim's temple, but I want to be able to interact with it. You know, I want to be part of a community. That's what I think would be best. I think that's what we should be trying to achieve. You know, it doesn't matter how we get there so much as the fact that we get there. That's what we really need to happen. We need to get to community, whether that's through the gates of eternity or through the tower, I don't know. But we're going to keep collecting information about it, and when the time comes, we're either going through the gates of eternity or climbing the tower. When we know which is more likely to get us to community, that's our goal now. That's what I want. Yeah, there's not really anything we can do back here. I found this area, but there's nothing here. Because we can't go back through with this thing. Oh, we can jam through there. Oh, we can get back here. Let's take this thing. So we're back here, back at the start. Is anyone here? This is where we began, but there's nobody here. I was hoping we'd find someone, or at least something would happen, but there's nothing here. It's all exactly as we left it. Okay. Well, that's a bit of a letdown. I was hoping we'd find somebody here, but not the case. Anyway, side note, guys, I did turn down my mouse sensitivity because I thought maybe that would help with the jerkiness, because I know we've had a problem up to this point with the mouse being really jerky. So hopefully that improves things for you a little bit, guys. It's still going to be a bit jerky sometimes, because sometimes we're going to get some lag. But I think it'll be a bit of an improvement, so that's good. Anyway, we're going to make our way back now. There's another jammer, isn't there? Yeah. So, that's kind of my explanation to you guys. That's what we want. Community is our eventual goal here. Obviously, we're going to continue to collect information, both because it's fun to continue to learn about the story, and also because we need more information to determine what path is most likely to get us to community. So we'll figure it out. Hopefully, in figuring out how we get to community, we also learn a lot more as we go about the simulation, because it's really an interesting mystery. But now I have a decision-making process, and that is really pleasing to me. I'm really glad that I have that now. Because I was kind of wandering aimlessly, fearing commitment, because I didn't feel I had enough information to solve the problem of where to go and what to do. I was kind of trying to walk the line between the two paths, you know? And now, I'm still going to continue to do that, but that line has something at the end of it. It's not just sideways that we need to go to get somewhere, if you know what I mean, you know? Because there's the Gates of Eternity on the left, the tower on the right, but in the center, on the line we're walking, there's community, and that's our goal, not just, you know, to continue to wander aimlessly between the two other locations. Anyway, we're gonna head back to the Land of Death, because either way, we need the rest of the sigils here to complete all the tasks. So we gotta come back here. Hopefully we get more details, too, because we kind of broke sequence a little bit in going straight to the Land of Faith and reading some of the archive documents. Anyway, how far did we get? We got through at least 4, I think, right? Yeah, we beat 4. We did not finish 5, so let's come back. I'm not going to read the documents again, because we've already done that. We're just going to go ahead and do some of the puzzles here. I don't know, maybe we didn't. I'm going to open it up. I'm pretty sure we're not going to be able to talk to the archive anymore, but it looks like, actually, there is some new stuff. Though their forms are loathsome to behold, they are not evil, for they are the servants of the gods. They're blessed doorkeepers and guardians of the holy paths. Their charge is to judge whether we are worthy to pass the gates that lead to Aru. And so they challenge us with riddles or in combat. Some say that it is not so, that there are ancient gods whose names have been forgotten, and spirits of darkness whose name none have ever known, that these must be avoided at all costs. Serve a greater purpose in ways that Osiris has not revealed to us. So basically here, what we're seeing is, it's kind of like what Elohim told us when we first got killed by one of the turrets. They mean us no harm. They're here to challenge us. That's kind of what the point is of that. You know, the reason why we're going through all these puzzles and facing all these dangers is not because Elohim wants us... Ooh, I accidentally clicked. It's not because Elohim wants us to suffer, but because we're supposed to, you know, grow. Okay, I promise I'll be home soon. Maybe a couple of weeks. I know, but what we're doing here is important, and the team needs my help. I'm not going to wait until it's too late, I promise, but there's so much we have to set up, so much that has to work for a very, very long time. It does, yes. Work on one of these supercomputers, and EO is pretty much the best there is. Rock stars and mad geniuses. Dad would totally be geeking out. Oh, so he's not allowed to tell him. That's confusing. I wonder why... Oh, I love this. I didn't actually read the title. I started reading the note. Wow, that's a fun title. Coming soon, your son in 3D. I love how lively all the characters are in these excerpts. It's really fun. Anyway, yeah, so... maybe this is the guy that wrote the message about hope, because I don't think it had an author, but we did see it. This was just a blog post, right? Yeah, blog 24. All right. What is the point of being alive? I know it's an old question and not one that's easy to answer. But I mean, if you're reading this, you are alive. And someday you will stop being alive. Both of these facts are incontrovertible. Not necessarily if we're a robot inside a simulation. Most likely we will stop being alive, but technically if the computer never shuts down, we could go on forever, unless we got reset. So what about it then? Don't you wonder? Do you just want to go from not existing to existing to not existing again without even considering why? You right now, as you sit there reading this, why do you exist? What is the purpose of your life? Do you have one? Should you have one? Is it better to have a purpose or not? When you approach death, will you feel that your life had meaning? If so, why? If not, why not? What defines whether a life was good or not? It may seem abstract right now, but that moment just before death will come. It is inevitable. If you don't ask yourself these questions, how will you face that moment? It's a good point. I mean, we all like to put off thinking about that tough stuff. But ultimately, it's very important. Because, you know, that's really what it's all about. Oh, there's a bonus star up there. I didn't notice that. Yeah, ultimately, you have to consider the meaning of life and what you've done and how you did it, how you treated others, all that stuff. It's good advice, frankly. A lot of these things, Alley of the Pressure Plates, a lot of the things we've seen in the excerpt so far are great advice, not just for us here, as we're in the simulation, but in general in life. That's something you have to think about. And obviously our purpose is still difficult to decipher at this point in the simulation. It's still something you have to consider. That's something that's a little unclear. I mean, the general purpose of the robots is to preserve, humanity and all the work we've done and pass it on to life, at least in some form, and thought in terms of some higher form. So, I think we want to... Actually, no, we want to drop this here. So, obviously, that's the general purpose of the robots, but... What's a little unclear is, what's the purpose of, us specifically, you know? I mean, I guess it's a little confusing what our specific role is. Like, I guess the version, we must have been a previous version, and we got reset for us to have been, waking up. I mean, I don't know what version number we are, so... I don't know what our, hang on, let me put this down here. Oh. That's confusing. I put it down just now then. Okay. So when I put down this connector, I'll place this, and then I can get back here. Do I need the connector to do this, though? Yeah, I do. I need a connector. Okay. So let me run back with the hexahedron before the recording ends. I actually need this thing. Please don't stop recording. Don't stop, don't stop, don't stop. I need to place that down and grab... Ah, dang it. Shoot. Uh-oh. I may have just trapped myself. Hold X to reset. Okay, cool. So it does detect when you get stuck. That's good. Alright. So, anyway, yeah, I guess the reason why we are here, in terms of the story, is that, we were, reset at some point. Unless we're a new robot. That would be kind of confusing, you know? Are we new? I guess we could be. Maybe we are new. Maybe we're a totally new personality. From all the previous robots. Because some of them, you know, have those progeny programs that follow them. I guess it could be the case that we're a totally new one. But more likely to me is that we got reset. Because we made a mistake, according to the story. To me, that seems most likely. So I'm gonna go out here, place this down, get all the way to the end, and come around. So here we go. We have access to the back now. That's cool. Okay, so we got back here. What does that do? Because we're about to have our way back this way shut off. But I guess we can restart if we feel we need to now. So. Oh, it says hold X to reset. It looks like it thinks we're stuck. Are we, though? It clearly thinks so. We might be. I don't know if we are. I don't think we... Oh, yeah, we are. Yeah, we are. Because we can't get both of these out. Yeah, we can't get both of these out of here, can we? No, we can't even get one of them out here, can we? I don't think so. I don't think we can get them out. Yeah. We can't. Okay, so I think we screwed it up. Let's hold X to reset. Yeah, let's do this. Okay, guys, I figured it out. This is actually a pretty simple puzzle. All we really have to do is take advantage of the fan. I keep forgetting when I'm doing these puzzles that I can utilize the fan. But this is the key. We can take the fan off and use it on pressure plates. So anyway, what we need to do, guys, is we need to take the cube and the connector. We need to record ourselves standing on this pressure plate for a while to give ourselves enough time to actually place down the cube and connector properly. So we're gonna do that first. We're gonna give ourselves a good, you know, 15 seconds or so to get it done. There we go. So we're gonna go stand over there. We're gonna place down the cube. We're gonna place down the connector. Please tell me I can do this quickly enough. Yep. Okay. There we go. That's all we needed to do. So now, this is open, right? The next step is we need to record ourselves. Wait, hang on. What we need to do now, I think, is we need to record ourselves standing on this. Yeah. So we can grab the fan, the connector, the cube, all that stuff. And then the virtual ones, the recorded ones, will still be there holding the gate open. So then we'll come over here, stand here, hold this one open, and then we'll use our three objects to open the last three gates to get over there. That's how it'll go. Okay, guys? So we're gonna record ourselves standing right here for at least, like, 10 seconds. Alright, that should be plenty of time. So the first 20 seconds we'll spend there. And then we'll spend another 20 seconds or so over here to make sure we have plenty of time to complete the puzzle. So basically, guys, my problem with this one, and this one actually took me longer than you're gonna see on YouTube here, because I cut some of it out, because it really took a long time. It took me a long time just because I wasn't thinking about the fan as something I could use. I'd forgotten that I can utilize it. So we need to get everything out of here. Come on. Thank you. So we need to grab this. Grab the connector. Come on. Get me that. Okay. There we go. So we're good. We need to bring all these things over for when we open this up. 20 seconds might not be enough. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Grab the fan. Go, 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 go. Okay, and get over here before the video stops playing. Done. Okay, made it. 3 seconds to spare. Wow, that was tough. Okay, yeah, so I just have to remember that the fan is something I can utilize. You know, it's not just a stationary object. There's a fan and, you know, a platform for it, so I can utilize it in multiple ways. I've been running this gauntlet for generations trying to find the right answers. I am fast coming to the conclusion that there are none. Who? I can't remember who came before Dog. I remember we saw a death message and someone, someone's progeny program was dog. I don't remember. Yeah. So clearly, he's gone through several versions trying to find the answers he's meant to. Okay, anyway, let's do another puzzle here. We might not have time for much more. Myself and our two jammers. Okay. So, anyway, again, I just need to remember that I can record myself multiple times to solve one puzzle. I don't have to do it all in one recording, and I don't have to leave the fan in one place. That's why that puzzle gave me some trouble, because I'm not thinking about that stuff in the right way. Anyway, we need to probably record ourselves standing right here, and then jam some things, right? I figure. Anyway, hang on. Let's actually take this jammer, because we have one right here. Yeah, so I'm guessing we're only going to have one jammer for the whole puzzle. It's just, it said two jammers because you can record yourself using it as well. So, what I'm thinking is, are there two guns? No, actually, it looks like there's just one gun here in this phase. Okay. Is there another recorder back here? No, there's just one as well. Okay. So what I'm thinking is we need to record ourselves standing on the pressure plate so that we can jam that thing, that gun over there, right? That'll get us into the next room, but then we have another pressure plate to deal with and another gun, okay? So we need to... Ultimately, we're going to have to jam... Ultimately, we have to record ourselves utilizing both jammers, probably. Because we only get one recorder, it looks like. Okay. I'm trying to see what this says. It's too pixelated, really, to understand. What about the other stuff? Yeah, the words are really grayed out, but everything else about it looks pretty clear. Anyway, so, we need to get in there, and preferably with a jammer, so that means we're definitely going to have to record ourselves. Okay. So here's what I think we have to do. I'm guessing what we need to do is start with this here. Let's record ourselves here, because we need this open, and then we can actually stand on that pressure plate as our recorded self, and that might be enough to get us through. I think it will be. So we want to give ourselves plenty of time to do this. I think, but we're going to be stuck inside there, so I don't think this is going to work. Yeah, but I'll just play now. So now we have this jammer here, which allows us to get through. And at the very least, we can come look at what's in here. And it looks like, yeah, there's no other recorder. We have, okay, 16 seconds. Yeah, so we just need to get in there. Yeah, so there's not much here. Let's get back before we get stuck. Okay, there we are. So here's the issue. Again, we need to get in there as our recorded self and stand on that pressure plate. The problem is, to do that, we need to have that gun jammed, which we can't really do. Actually, hang on. Can I jam through this if I record myself standing on this? Yeah, let's try that, okay? Done. So can I jam through here? Leave that there, right? Now when the recording ends, will it still jam the gun? It looks like it actually can't do that. Like it gets blocked off. Okay. That's fine. That's fine. Alright. So what we want to do is probably... Oh, I get it. I think maybe if we jam... Well, we won't jam this gate, but we'll jam... Oh, actually, what we could do... We could try standing here while recording, then jam this wall open from the other side. That might help. But then what do we do next? Okay, so then we'd have to record ourselves, come inside, jam that, then go stand on the pressure... Yeah, I think I get it. Okay. So basically, step one, come here, stand here for a few seconds. Okay. Good enough. So then we do that, we play it, we jam from the other side. There we go. Alright. And then basically what we have to do now is record ourselves again. We're gonna come through. I don't know if we can actually trigger this. Because we're gonna have to take the jammer. We're gonna have to jam that. And then come over here for a really long time. And stand on this. I don't know if we can do it. What I think might work, though, is if we stand here with that jammed, eventually, you see how it has a 5-minute limit on the bottom? When that hits 5 minutes, it'll probably autoplay the recording, which means we don't actually have to go back and trigger the recorder ourselves. We can actually just stand here for 5 minutes, and then when the recorder starts playing this recording, we're gonna come through, grab the real jammer, come around through this gate, jam that gun, and then we can go get the sigil. So I'm gonna wait till this 5-minute timer has elapsed, and then I'll bring it back in, okay?
Have no fear. Return another time, and the answer may reveal itself.
Elohim thinks I have no idea what I'm doing, but I actually know exactly what I'm doing. The time is about to run out anyway, guys. So here we go. 5 more seconds, and then the recording should automatically play. Is it gonna play? Oh, does it not play? Oh, I thought it was gonna automatically play. Huh. Looks like it doesn't do that. Oh, maybe it doesn't. Okay. So we need a different solution. Dang it, Elohim did know that I had no idea what I was doing. I had a totally incorrect idea. I thought it would automatically play it, but looks like that's not how it works. Okay. So, it isn't gonna work like that. We need a new strategy. I thought we could kind of cheat the system like that, but that's not how it works, clearly. So anyway, we can record ourselves with the jammer. You know, we can kind of come over here, jam the gun for a little while, stand on the pressure plate, but then we have to come back here eventually, take our jammer and jam this again so we can play the recording. So I think we'll do this for now. We'll record ourselves. We're gonna jam the gun. And we'll go stand on the pressure plate for a short while. We'll say, like, 20 seconds, just to make sure that there's plenty of time for us to handle things. So yeah, this should be fine. We'll actually go to 30, just because sometimes, you know, things don't work quite the way you expect, and you want to make sure you don't screw up and have to reset. So there we go. 30 seconds, plenty of time to get it done. Now what we do is we come back, we turn this around, we jam the door, and we play the recording. So we're actually gonna pick this up. The gun is now jammed. He's gonna open this for us. We're gonna jam that, nope, jam the gun. Okay. So that's actually really simple. I don't have much time though, so I gotta get out of here. Let's go, get out, done, okay. Oh, and this opens, so just in case your recording isn't timed properly, you can still get out. Okay. Yeah, so I was just thinking I could cheat the system by just waiting for the 5 minutes to expire, but you ultimately don't actually need it. You can just reuse the jammer. I was thinking, okay, well, I'll just leave everything in one place and then roll from here, but it's actually easier doing it this way anyway. So there we go. anyway, guys, we are pretty much out of time today, so I hope you have enjoyed. Please remember to like and subscribe if you did. This has been the Chaldonut speaking goodbye, friends, and I will see you all next time with some more of the Talos Principle.